Bloody hell!
Never seen one like him before.
Thank you.
grey like my grandmum.
Greetings, Ibeer.
Greetings, Geralt. How might I be of help?
Listen, would you craft something for me? What do you have on offer? So long.
I'm done with you! You'll square your kidneys!
Boring as fucking...
But, sir...
Anyone there? You can come out. It's safe now.
A witcher.
What happened?
Nilfgaardians came plundering, looking for valuables, as if we was rich.
Who killed them? Couldn't have been you.
I don't know. Must have been those beasts you slaughtered.
Something stinks, and I don't mean the corpses.
That's how it was. I dwell on it.
Your choice. Not about to stay where I'm not wanted.
Always good to hear wise words. Farewell. What brings you here?
Saw your notice. Can anyone tell me about the monster?
I can't. The patrol has been lost. Somewhere along the south shore of Lake Windomer. We must know why.
What makes this Witcher's work?
Some brickmakers live south of here. They call their village Byways. Almost empty now. Many have run away. They speak of a monster which kills. Redanians do not patrol there. That would be foolish. And robbers do not attack Imperials. That would be even more foolish. This leaves one option. A monster.
Just so happens I've been to Byways. Your patrol went there too.
Yes? What of them?
They're dead. Lots of ghouls there now, drawn by the stench of corpses. Wouldn't advise going there.
We will bury them with honors, as heroes. Your reward, well deserved.
Of course I do.
I have a gift for you. Because Mummy always said, if someone's nice, you gotta thank them.
If only more people believed that.
I best be going. Auntie says I'm not to stray far from home.
Wise words. Be careful. And thanks for the gift.
That mug's a fright.
That's it, Roach.
Faster.
Go! Whoa there, Roach!
My dad doesn't like elves very much. Are you an elf?
Oh.
Why?
Every sinner will burn in eternal fire.
Know what they say about you lot? If you seek justice, hire a witcher.
What are they doing?
Wait. Overgrown wains, you see. Have you any children, Geralt?
None.
Oh, yes. Forgot witches is sterile. Well, don't just stare at me. Tell me what brings you.
Got something for you.
I love gifts, but I prefer to unwrap them in private. Oi, lads, mind the barrels. Going out for a jabber with Geralt. Come. Oh, that's better. All right, what do you have for me?
Max Persody's house, as requested.
Papers. Where are they?
Left them in the vault. You wanted the house, you got the house. Never mentioned its contents.
You're a quick study. Already as tricky as Odim himself. Keen to ridicule a man. Do you know what I and the company do with your type?
Dunno. Ask for legal advice? Looks to me like you might need some. You signed the contract, Olgierd. I'm just fulfilling its terms, to the letter. Unhappy? Hell, should have chosen your words more carefully.
Yes, I should have. I assume you came to an agreement with Horst. Shame. A right horse in that one.
His brother Ewald was worse.
Was?
Horst killed him with his own hands.
It's progress.
Horst's brother. Did you know about him?
I should think so. Ewald was famous in certain circles.
Which ones?
The kind noble witches don't usually associate with. He murdered for coin, no questions. Without batting an eye. Always extravagantly, though. If not for his damn sir, I believe I'd have invited him to join the company.
Why did you even need those papers?
To sink the Borsodis, naturally. You see, I learned of an interesting clause in old man Maximilian's will. It states that his sons must meet and shake hands in agreement at least once a year at Bellatay. Failing that, the auction house must be auctioned off. The proceeds to go to Vilmarius Hospital.
Guess the old man sensed what might happen.
Aim to deliver those papers to the right hands. Borsodi would have landed in the streets. And the hospital would have gotten the funds it needs to treat orphans and beggars pro bono.
Awfully noble of you, showing so much concern for the needy.
I couldn't give a rat's arse about the needy. May they wither and disappear along with the city. I wanted one thing. Revenge.
The Borsodis. What's your gripe? Get kicked out of an auction?
Worse. They evicted me from my home. Are you really interested?
All in all, not really. Just asking out of courtesy.
Commendable manners. Well, why do you stand there? Do you need something still?
Dead brother had himself one more day like those of old.
Very easy to say. But have you got any proof?
I do.
Vladimir's hand is unmistakable. You've done well, Witcher. Need something else?
I've seen a saber like that. What's its origin?
A fear. It was a gift. Any soft-armed craven can hang a blade from his belt, prance about feigning danger. But my saber's a promise. If I reach for it, heads will roll. Mere sight of it quells the urge to duel in shavers eager to face Olgierd von Everick, the infamous outlaw.
My medallion seems to think it's magic.
It thinks, eh? And I think you've never seen a better weapon.
Your band. Chosen some interesting specimens.
Interesting? How so? Common carousers and roughnecks. Every last one.
Where'd you dig them up?
Some have been with me ages. Others are gathered on the road. And a few fell with themselves. They're company for drink and sport, at least. And ever since I began travelling with him, my old enemies have sat quiet as moles.
Third wish. Time you stated it.
A moment, Geralt. I must see to something. Then we'll chat. You there. Yank the herring out the barrel.
This dallying.
Now, ready to listen? Or do you still not give two shites about what I've got to say?
I'm ready. I'm listening.
Good. You'll return to your lord and tell him as follows. His demand was brazen. Hurt me to the core. For I was brought up to respect the sacred law of hospitality. And I shall not bend to an uncouth boor's dictum. Understood. I will pay him a visit shortly to test his willingness to adapt. So you ride off and announce me. And don't spare your horse. Got it?
Aye, got it.
Give this man a mount and leave him go. Come with you. We must talk outside. The Aethiri believe one should only discuss important matters out of doors, with the gods as witnesses.
Fulfilled two of your wishes. Time I learned the third.
Confident, aren't you? Proud, sure of your strengths. Fearless.
Third task, if you don't mind.
Mutations. They stripped you of emotion. Tell me, have you ever loved? I mean, truly loved?
You don't give a shit, Olgierd.
You'd make piss-poor company for a talk about love anyway.
Third wish. Still waiting to hear it.
Aye, aren't you stubborn? Fine. Listen well. I had a wife once. The day I saw her last, I gave her a rose. A violet one. Bring me that blue. Wouldn't mind reminding myself what it looks like.
When was that? How long's it been? Flowers wilted and turned to dust by now.
You wished to hear a wish. Now you have. Fulfill it. I ride now to visit this dauntless, but one of my men will remain here. He'll know how to find me. That is, of course, should you succeed.
At least you can tell me where your wife is.
In my old manor, east of Martin Foy's farmstead. I'd wish you godspeed, but, well, you understand, I'm sure. Goodbye, Geralt.
Join you. Help the poor bloke out.
Ugly bastard. Come on, Roach. damage.
It's me, brothers!
Listen, Buckthorn, I thought I was done for. Me hut's always open to you.
Kendrick, you there?
Not so loud.
Ah! God, scared me off to...
Not so loud, I said. Fog's not natural. Could be something in there hiding. Foglets or air nymphs, for example. Don't want to attract them. Believe me.
Foglets? Oh, sweet mother Melitele, why'd I ever come here?
Good question. What are you doing here?
See, Kendrick and me, we thought man has been empty all these years, full of fine things going to rot.
So you're a thief?
Thief steal from the living? What's the harm taking from the dead? Kendrick went to open a door. I stood watch. Suddenly heard his lamp smash. Then nothing. Quiet. Called out to him, but... What was that? One of them foglets you spoke of?
No.
Phew. That's a stone off my...
I'll see what that was and look for your partner. You...
I ain't about to wait around. I'm out of here.
Pretty sprawling, this estate. How am I gonna find that rose in this fog? Fresh manure. Water's ice cold. Mountain stream cold. A grave here? I'd scooch along, Kitty. This place. What's that? That. Digging. A lockpick? Must have been the other thieves. From cleated boots, leading from the back of the garden. Graves, unmarked, laid out in rows, like garden beds.
Hey. Hear me?
Another thief. Body's mutilated.
Who are you?
Thank you.
Was that? No eyes or nostrils, deformed organs. Damn thing had no right to be alive.
Well, philosophers do still debate what it means to be alive, exactly.
Normally I'd be shocked, but not after what I just saw. Who are you two?
Clearly not animals. Think of us as friends of the house.
What about this thing? What can you tell me? Friend of yours?
We called him the Caretaker.
Doesn't look like any creature I've ever seen. Where'd it come from?
From very far away. He was summoned to guard Lady Iris and the home. He tended the garden, took care of unwanted guests.
Very far away, meaning where exactly?
The name of this place would mean naught to you.
What's with the show? The pretense that you're animals. You couldn't have warned me?
No. We're obliged to maintain discretion.
So why talk to me at all?
Why? Well, we get so few chances to talk to humans, and we're curious to know what brought you.
Gonna need a better answer than that.
Later.
You know the master of the house, the owner?
Olgierd von Everick. Yes, we know him, but he left, and his wife became mistress of the house.
Great. So, Lady von Everick home? Could you announce me, say she has a guest?
Why do you wish to see her?
I'm here to get the violet rose Olgierd gave Iris just before he left.
Iris is inside, in the bedchamber upstairs. Take his key. It opens the rear door.
Guess I'll make my own introductions. So, how should I address you?
As you did now. We'd rather keep our names to ourselves.